It's about that time of day again. My name is Joseph. It's Tuesday evening, June 13th. Welcome back to your nightly newsletter. We're covering crude oil, S&P, gold, euro, and DAX tonight. Crude is bearish ahead of the inventory report tomorrow, and a strong spike lower is telling us be ready for one of four possible scenarios tomorrow. The S&P is bullish with a wide channel. That wide channel tells us to add that midline and use that support, looking for two-legged pullbacks and traps off the highs for Wednesday. Gold is bullish with a channel, but we're getting too close to the measured move target overhead, so the plan is to avoid buying high and look for traps down in the battle zone tomorrow. Euro's range-bound with a triangle here tonight, which tells us to be buying the low, sell the high, avoid that middle, and focus on failures tomorrow. The DAX is bullish with an overshoot of a spike in channel, which tells us to look for a two-legged pullback to avoid chasing the move on Wednesday. Got a big, big day tomorrow. Tomorrow's Fed day. Tomorrow's inventory day. Tomorrow's the beginning of quad witching, this third week of the month of June. That's not going to stop us from putting together a great plan here for tomorrow. Got a great newsletter in store for you guys and gals tonight. Before we jump in though, I do want to remind you the only place to watch the full-length version of this video is on our blog here at sidewaysmarkets.com. If you're watching the video right now on our YouTube channel, not to worry, there's a link in the description of the YouTube video. Follow that link, come join me here on the blog at Sideways Markets and watch the full-length version. While you're here on the blog, don't forget, join the mailing list. I'll send you an email every evening when our nightly newsletter goes live. Follow me on social, lower left-hand corner, many different ways. We got Twitter, Facebook, LinkedIn, StockTwits. Follow me on social media, lower left-hand corner, always posting important charts, links, and updates throughout the week on social. Grab those charts. Don't forget, you can easily download all the charts from tonight's video. Have them ready on your computer for tomorrow's session. Don't forget to grab that free pass. You'll learn more with me in 90 minutes on that free pass than you will anywhere else on the interwebs. I can guarantee you that. Grab that free pass in the upper right-hand corner. And don't forget, if you're brand new here to SOT, we get a great frequently asked questions page, and I'm always here to answer all your questions if you have any questions along the way. Get a big day tomorrow. Let's get ready for tomorrow. Tomorrow's hump day. No, it's Fed day. It's inventory day. It's also the beginning of what should be right the next few days going into quadruple witching on Friday. Now, of course, we talked about this in last night's newsletter, right? Friday is June 16th. That is the third Friday of the month. As we get later in this week, we do expect to see volume drop and volatility increase as traders are forced to balance their portfolios ahead of all four asset classes expiring on Friday. With that said, we also had the beginning of the FOMC meeting today. Tomorrow is the FOMC announcement at 2 p.m. Eastern time. Whenever you have the FOMC announcement, right, we know, of course, 2 p.m. Eastern time tomorrow. That basically tells me two things. One, stay the heck away from those markets at 2 p.m. Eastern time tomorrow afternoon, because they are going to be unpredictable and extremely volatile. I would never recommend a new trader to go risking real capital gambling right on major news events such as the FOMC meeting announcement. Remember, there's no reality around these news events, right? It doesn't matter what comes out of the mouths of the FOMC tomorrow. It's all going to be emotion-based, right? Fear and greed-based reactions. So it's very, very difficult to really use any methodical, any strategy of trading those reactions. So be very, very careful with that tomorrow. The second thing it tells me is early in, early out. The big traders in the market aren't going to be able to get out of positions easily if they stay in too late in the session tomorrow. So my rule of thumb on Fed day is usually 10:30, 10:45, 11 o'clock. Be watching that time closely, because as the volume starts to get lower, you'll start seeing that market sort of flutter around on low volume. That's your cue that we're done for tomorrow morning. So get to it early. Don't gamble away your hard-earned capital, right, your risk capital tomorrow around that FOMC announcement. You're more than welcome to wait until after the announcement comes out and give it a few minutes afterwards, but be very, very, very careful. As I always remind you, there are so many times each week, each month, for us to find reliable trading opportunities. Those are not going to be around major news events. Now, that's not the only big powerhouse news event tomorrow. We also have the inventory report tomorrow morning for crude oil traders at 10:30 a.m. Eastern time. This means the window for crude traders tomorrow is going to be a little bit smaller. The cutoff for that 10:30 announcement is 10:15 on Wednesdays. So like we talked about for the FOMC announcement, early in, early out tomorrow. After 10 a.m. on Wednesdays, for at least for crude oil traders, we oftentimes see very difficult time finding reliable trades. So get to it early tomorrow. The cutoff, of course, is going to be at 10:15. Now, one more thing about that inventory report tomorrow morning. We do have some support and resistance levels that we're going to be using that are specific to that report tomorrow morning. I'm going to post those below the video tonight on the blog. It'll also be on the chart here for crude tonight, which we'll see in a moment. If you want to grab those levels, just scroll down below the video on the blog at Sideways Markets. There's a link that says click here to read more. Follow that link and that will take you into the full commentary, and you can see the right, you can see all the commentary for crude oil and all the levels of support and resistance we'll be using for tomorrow. You'll see that more in detail as we go through the rest of this video here tonight. Other than those two big powerhouse news events, right, the inventory report at 10:30 and the FOMC announcement, again, tomorrow's going to be very much an early in, early out scenario, almost a half day for experienced traders. Most experienced traders will come back the following day on Thursday and they'll trade the reaction then. It's a lot more stable, a lot more reliable, it's a lot more liquid, right? It's a safer environment. And people learn their lesson, right? Experienced traders who have been around the block a few times, they know better than to go risking their capital on news events like the inventory report, right, at the FOMC announcement. Now, outside of that, we get some news coming out of Europe tomorrow morning at 5 a.m. We get the industrial production number coming at 5 a.m. That'll be the big headline number tomorrow in the London session. And then, of course, if you're with me tomorrow morning in the trade room, we open up, of course, at 8 o'clock Eastern time. We get consumer prices and retail sales, the big numbers there tomorrow, right, 8:30 a.m. Eastern time. So we had a good peppering of news early in the session tomorrow morning, 5 a.m. and, of course, 8:30 a.m. And we're going to need it because we definitely need to get this smart, right? Get these markets moving early tomorrow morning, because again, we don't want to be left holding the bag as we get later in the session tomorrow morning. So early in, early out, get to it early, get out of there early. Don't gamble away that hard-earned capital, right, on those unreliable news events, right? And again, a lot of traders will be waiting patiently for that news to come out. Give it a few minutes afterwards, and then trade the reaction once, right, once the dust settles, right, from that news event. All right, guys, let's jump right in. We got the S&P, we got crude, we got gold. We'll grab some Euro, some FDAX tonight. Starting off tonight here with the S&P. S&P is bullish with a wide bull channel and running into a measured move resistance, which tells us to look for a two-legged pullback and traps below prior swings to avoid buying too close to this level of resistance tomorrow. Now, a couple things stand out here on this S&P chart for today. Obviously, we can see this big, big channel rotation here, right? And we're up around the high of that channel. That big channel tells us, let's go back down to that low and let's buy the low of that channel, right? That's the first thing that stands out, is this kind of big move going higher. The second thing here that stands out is in the short term, if we look kind of inside the middle half of that wide channel, yeah, I get some pretty good rotation up there. That's a spike in channel. A spike in channel, which we'll talk more about in a moment on crude oil, right? A spike in channel says, look at some prior swings and try to find some traps, right? Try to find some traps, right? Trap low, trap low, trap low, right? So you can see some overlap here. We have the bull channel, that large bull channel telling us we want to be buying off the low, buying off the low of that large bull channel. That's pretty simple to see. And then, of course, the spiking channel telling us to look for that trap low, right? Trap low. You can see everything's pretty much pointing down around this battle zone. Now, one more important clue here is clearly the measured move. AB equals CD. Now, the measured move is a great target, but look at where we are in relationship to this measured move. Would you say we're relatively close or relatively far away? I would say we're relatively close to that measured move. That means we are right next to the market's objective. Whenever we find ourselves at the market's objective, we no longer want to be a buyer into resistance, right? I want to be a buyer at support. So look left, find areas of support, prior swings, rising support trend lines, and again, you're seeing quite a bit of overlap. The measured move says, be careful buying high. look for a deep pullback to buy low. The bull channel says buy the low, right, of that channel. And of course, the spiking channel, right, says look for traps. So we're seeing multiple levels of confluence, right? We're seeing a lot of confluence right now on the S&P from three different technical tools. Now, of course, we have to assume as the market goes higher, right, they're probably hunting for that prior week high as the week develops. We may see that as a long-term target for tomorrow. But the goal right now is it's to focus our energy buying as low as possible. Now, how might that happen? Well, there are three scenarios you want to be looking for on the S&P tomorrow. One would be a trap, down below that 35 half. That would be the most aggressive. How about a failure, right? A failure here. How about we move below the moving average, come back to the moving average? You know, if I'm a seller here trying to call a top, I'm going to try to sell that pullback to the moving average. Well, if we see the sellers take the bait there, we can then look and see where their stops are going to be, and we can buy into their stops using a seller failure below the moving average. That's a second opportunity we have here tomorrow as well. Third opportunity, this one's a little bit more complicated. As we pull back, right, it forms a resistance trend line. Jump up, pull back, and go. I call this a two-legged pullback, right? Two-legged pullback. It usually incorporates a trend line coming down overhead. As you can see, all three of these scenarios, though, put us down in that battle zone, and they give us a chance to buy low, right, without buying high. Now, don't forget, this is the S&P, and we're going into Fed Day tomorrow, so keep an eye if price does keep going higher. What if price keeps going higher, doesn't pull back for us? That's perfectly fine. That'll be acceptance for the buyers, but I don't want to buy high. If we do end up seeing price push higher, look for a two-legged pullback. Basically, look for traps, right? Look for traps as the market tries to push higher. Anytime I find myself in a position where the only option to participate with the market is to buy high, I look for traps. Or sell low, I look for traps. That'll make sure that I'm buying low, right, and selling high. What would it take to make this market bearish tomorrow? It's possible, right? Anything can happen, and I don't care what direction I trade in. How does it turn bearish? First of all, strong move down, get that moving average to come over, and hold that pullback, right? If the bears can hold that pullback on strength, we'll gladly give us the bears tomorrow, and they'll be hunting for a retest of that low. Be careful, though, trying to call reversals, because you know what the buyer's looking for. If those bears fail, the buyers will be looking to run this right back up the flagpole, right, to retest that high tomorrow. So the key word for the S&P tomorrow is get in early, right, for Fed Day, right? Get in early ahead of Fed Day tomorrow. Again, three things right now telling us to buy that dip. If it does push higher into the announcement tomorrow, don't take the bait, don't chase the market, and look for those traps. Moving from the S&P now, how about some crude oil? Boy, that crude got tossed around today like a rag doll. Crude is bearish after this afternoon's API report quickly erased all the gains in the bulls this afternoon. And this strong spike lower tells us to be looking for a spike in channel, a spike in wedge, a spike in range, or possibly a flag pattern and a target going back down to the lows tomorrow. Now, keep in mind, tomorrow's inventory day for crude oil. So the plan, as we said earlier, is to get to our trades before that news hits. Avoiding the temptation to gamble away our risk capital when the news hits at 10:30 a.m. Eastern time tomorrow. Boy, what a day here on crude. Spent the day today looking short here for the more, right, for the first half of the session. Then, of course, right, the bears fail at the prior day low. We saw that this morning in our trade room, and didn't take long for the bulls to take it right back and run this sucker right back up to new highs. Well, that didn't last very long, as you can see. The paint had barely dried on this brand new spike and channel, right? And of course, we hear from the API report today at 4:30 p.m. Eastern time. Now, that API report helps me create these inventory levels for tomorrow. Not to worry, I've also posted a copy of these same levels below tonight's video. If you go to sidewaysmarkets.com, scroll right down the link that says click here to read more, click that link, and that will take you over here to the they'll take you to the specific section where you can read more about the inventory levels for tomorrow. Those will be short-term support and resistance levels. They'll be good until the closing bell tomorrow, right, tomorrow evening. And, of course, the very first thing you look at this chart is this big, big spike down. This big spike down is a little bit too strong to be a bull market right now. It's a little bit too much, I think, to call this a pullback in a bull market, right? It might be. I hope to be able to get my hands on you guys one day as a brand new client. Don't forget, if you want to learn more about everything we do here at School of Trade, don't forget our free trial is one of the best in the business. If you're watching the video right now on our YouTube channel, not to worry. There's a link in the description of that YouTube video. Follow that link. Go to the website at schooloftrade.com, register as a new trial member, and learn more about our trading strategies here at School of Trade. Also, don't forget, while you're there, learn more about our beginner, intermediate, and advanced membership levels, and I'm always here standing by to answer all your questions, right, 24/7. What a great week we've had this week so far, third week of the month. Don't forget, tomorrow's Fed Day, tomorrow's Inventory Day. Tomorrow's going to be a great day, and we're going to follow that plan tomorrow morning in our trade room at 8 o'clock Eastern Time. Hope to see you guys there. My name is Joseph. Thanks for tuning in once again to our nightly newsletter, and I'll see you guys next time. Adios, amigos.